One thing that we consciously never did was to use our relationship for commercial purposes. We just believed that we needed to keep a space that was necessary. At the end of the day, what really pains people or hurts people a lot is not just picking up the threads and restructuring your life, because everything changes. Everything. So mom cooks every day, and mom does not enjoy cooking. And she cooks every day because she knows that if she doesn't cook, I'll go hungry. Physical activity. There is no greater contributor to happy hormones than physical activity.
The ethereal and enigmatic Dia Mirza had a heart-to-heart chat with us, and in this conversation she spoke to us about a whole bunch of things, including working with veteran actor Nagarjuna. She also opened up about her recent divorce from producer husband Sahil Sangha. Apart from that, she spoke to us about how she's been coping over the last couple of months and how she's handling household chores. Check it out.
While Dia Mirza has always been stunningly beautiful, she has emerged as one of the most thoughtful and deep-thinking celebrities in Bollywood. The star, who went through a split with husband Sahil Sangha recently, is finally opening up about how she handled this difficult phase in her life in an exclusive interview with Zoom. Dia, who played the on-screen version of Manyata in Sanju after a break and was recently seen in a critically acclaimed show on a streaming platform and the Tapsee Pannu starrer Thappad, opened up about her separation from producer Sahil Sangha.
We had so many people in the industry as our colleagues and friends, and I think one thing that we consciously never did was to use our relationship for commercial purposes. We never commodified our relationship consciously. So we never did photo shoots for magazines. We never did ads together. We didn't do these things because we just believed that we needed to keep a space that was necessary.
Talking about the difficult phase in both their lives, Dia shared that it was an emotionally trying time. The genuine messages of sympathy and kindness from their many fans and friends that gave them strength.
So many people reached out to us with such a sense of genuine heartache for us, you know, for both of us. And there was so much love in every message, like genuine love. At the end of the day, what really pains people or hurts people a lot is not just picking up the threads and restructuring your life, because everything changes. Everything. Everything. But what helps restructure, rebuild life is the knowledge that there is love and grace and humility and humanity offered in equal measures on both sides.
Dia is currently in lockdown with her mom and a house help, and the three women have made sure that they create some kind of routine to make sure that the house they live in is neat and tidy. And they try to make sure that most of the chores are completed in the first half of the day itself.
So mom and I are housemates, as we've always been. We also have one live-in help who, my God, I can't be more grateful for Sumitra. But the three of us are like soldiers at, you know, at work through the day, because we all believe that, you know, we want to continue to occupy a space that we've always occupied, which is clean and neat and comfortable. So we get down to work. But the good thing is that we're well planned and we're disciplined. So we finish most of our chores in the first half of the day. So mom cooks every day, and mom does not enjoy cooking, and she cooks every day because she knows that if she doesn't cook, I'll go hungry. I just made myself gluten-free pancakes.
In addition to her chores, Dia suggests a little bit of physical activity as a must, because being physically active releases feel-good hormones and staying positive mentally.
Physical activity. There is no greater contributor to happy hormones than physical activity. So whether it's home chores combined with yoga or dancing, whatever it is, I think it's so important to sweat it out. Perspire!
Well spoken indeed, Dia, and to see you be so positive in spite of the personal challenges that you have faced recently is indeed something we can all be inspired from.